know whether he's warning or not. It's these little things that put them ahead of the others.
Okay, draft three is underway, as you can see, three bands in. And again, no surprises so far.
Well, we wait for the first pick. I want to go back to that because I think another link that EG weakness that they showed was the fact that both Arteezy and Samael showed certain levels of over-aggression in game one. Game two, Samael showed some points as Storm Spirit. He was being the disruptive factor, but he did overextend a couple of times. They don't have a Pylite Die person on EG who really tanks smokes as well as Secret do.
So now that they just won against the Ember Spirit, they're inviting them to pick it again and perfectly comfortable with a Night Stalker first. Again, Evil Genius's Ember Spirit is not as scary as Team Secret, and I don't actually think they should have picked it in the first phase.
No, I agree with this. Whether they should have first picked the Night Stalker, I don't know, but I think they'd have to just at the off chance that Secret picks up both the Ember Spirit and the Night Stalker.
What was banned in game one in lieu of the Bane? Or game two, rather?
Winter Wyvern, I think? What?
No. Night Stalker. Okay, yeah.
Oh, in game two?
Game two, yeah, okay. Sorry.
Hope you're feeling comfortable with the Dazzle pick. It's two teams in the tournament that's been successful with it. Secret and obviously Oriental Gamers.
So are we going to see an Ember?
I mean, with the defensive hero of the Dazzle, it's really tempting, isn't it?
But versus a first pick Night Stalker, it's really not tempting. And after just losing with it, it's
also not
tempting.
What if they just go for like an Undying?
Because Evil Geniuses responded that sort of the Dazzle Undying with the Anti-Mage.
But yeah, what would you pair the Undying with as well? Because you're going to go into the next phase of bans. You're going to have for sure Tusk going to be banned away.
They could,
not necessarily. They haven't banned the Tusk away. They don't seem to mind the Tusk that much.
Well,
although
specifically, if
the problem is if they go for the Undying now, there's still an A in the pool, so they do follow up with the Tusk.
There's also WW still in the pool.
WW.
I would actually be fine with Winter Wyvern for EG here. I think it's usually a pretty decent response to Tusk. And it still leaves your draft very wide open.
I'd prefer the AA.
Maybe Ember themselves?
That'd be cheeky.
That would be cheeky.
PPD's like that, though.
Yes, isn't it?
And they don't have very good lockdown versus Ember Spirit. Tusk is the only stun so far, and he's very poor.
Or Darkseer, perhaps?
I don't think they want to commit to a Darkseer pick right now, just because the versatility in the draft, that they want to have Universe on the Night Stalker. They go for the Juggernaut again.
Juggernaut also leaves their laning options a lot, like very open. He's very strong in the offlane as a carry. Most of them like just simply don't have the option of being run the offlane, like Luna, Spectre, so on and so forth. And I think he was really good at controlling EE's farm.
This has been kind of the transition of the meta, it feels like, for 6.85, that teams started going dual lanes, but they were running like dual, you know, Undying Tusk, sort of dual off lanes. But then we're seeing Juggernauts and Gyrocopters actually then being carries rotated into the off lane to give even more preference to the off lane who has a greedier pickup usually.
So Secret have revealed pretty much nothing as of yet. Dazzle Tusk can fit into pretty much any lineup at all. So you guys keep talking about AA and Undying. Is there a reason why we haven't seen any of this?
Supposedly neither team thinks they're very good right now.
Wow.
You know, it's again this ever-changing, ever-developing meta game, especially amongst the top teams. They figure out what the strengths and weaknesses of the enemy is, and they adjust their draft accordingly. And apparently, EG and Secret feel like neither of those heroes are worthwhile picking up against the enemy.
This time around, it means the Nyx Assassin is left open, but yep. Team Secret, they mean a four-position Tusk. I don't see a huge amount of value in the Nyx Assassin against NS or Juggernaut yet. I think it's much better than leaving the Meepo out in the pool.
Hmm.
I also think if you pick a squishy hero like AA early, it invites the bounty hunter pick. Like the Juggernaut and the Nightstalk are like not really vulnerable at all to the early bounty hunter room.
Yeah, I think that's a good point. That the potential Pilot Die bounty hunter is actually incredibly disruptive for heroes like Ancient Apparition, Rubik. I wouldn't mind a Darkseer ban here from Team Secret in the second round, just because EG could pick up like their support and they go for the Darkseer fourth pick. They go for the Sumail Timbersaw instead.
I guess with the Dazzle, there always raises the question of whether or not they will run a Huskar for E, but with AA still in the pool and Juggernaut as on the opposite team, I don't think it's that likely that we'll see Huskar. I'm really curious as to who got first pick and like who chose first pick and or second pick inside, because EG got first pick and Dire.
What about Templar Assassin here for Team Secret? They already have some minus armor and physical damage. I would say it's not bad against the heroes of EG necessarily.
I don't think they usually pick it in the third pick. Maybe we might see fourth pick.
But yeah.
Yeah, fourth maybe more so. Because then I think you just go with the Darkseer for EG and TA will just have a miserable time.
Thinking, feeling we won't get to see the Templar Assassin with the Wind Ranger being picked up.
So now what matches up well mid versus the Wind Ranger though? There's still the Queen of Pain, I guess, for Sumail, but as we saw before, you can play most of the matchups versus the Wind Ranger.
I'm trying to point out, 27 picks so far for Frankfurt for Wind Ranger, win rate of 33%.
For now, I think the Queen of Pain is actually fine. I mean, she's not, it's not like Tuscan Wind Ranger has a whole lot of problems with her, but I think she's going to have, at the same time, she's going to have a good game against those guys, and I think Dazzle is struggling a bit. Playing up against the Queen of Pain.
She's also better in the matchup than like Alina would be, which would be perhaps your other hero to look to win the matchup against Wind Ranger. And Lina suffers against Tusk most notably.
But maybe the Nyx Assassin is too big of a threat still for them to want to commit to it yet.
Yeah.
A lot of single target coming out from Team Secret with PPD's hero.
Yeah, they're probably contemplating a support hero right now because they want, like PBD Zero, because they want to sit on the Queen of Pain pick until they can ban out the Nyx on their last one. Or even they might go for an Anti-Mage ban as well.
Are they scared of Anti-Mage though? Can't they aggro versus that?
Right now they're not. I think that they're trying to hone in on are they going for what kind of support they're going for and what kind of offlane they're going for and whether or not Anti-Mage is going to be an issue. The good part about this is that the mag is banned. They do go for the Ember Spirit.
Wow. Right back at you, Team Secret.
Cheeky indeed. Have we seen EE play Wind Ranger at all?
No, it's a Weehaw hero through and through. He's so good on it.
He is.
It'd be like just making Weehaw play the Ember Spirit. I'm sure they can, but
I just wonder if they want to put something else mid, perhaps, versus the Ember. They can dominate him a little bit harder than the Wind Ranger.
I think we may very well see the Dazzle just go in and help him help out a lot.
We have seen Sumail run into the offlane, though, too, with the Ember Spirit, so you don't even know where it's going to be.
Yeah, I was about to say, it's still opening Evil Geniuses. You talked about the dual lane potential. Like, they could just as easily leave Ember Spirit safe lane, run support with Juggernaut in the off lane.
So who plays Tiny?
It's a good question, because we will oftentimes play the mid-Tiny. I don't see I mean, Push still running Eternal Envy.
Push comes to shop, they can put Misery on the Wind Ranger.
I don't think they need to, though. What's the reason why they picked the Tiny, though? I guess three melee heroes, Craggy, if the game goes late, maybe instant disables versus Ember Spirit, but
I mean, Anti-Mage doesn't make much sense right now, and normally they always go for the empowered Anti-Mage. Whenever they pick it, they seem to have the mag to back it up. Just the Undying Finger.
I think EG's lanes are looking much, much stronger than Secret's at this point for melee heroes, though.
That's really the melee factor right now that is concerning, but...
There's that Ancient Apparition that Jacob was looking for, and I agree, I think that...
Would you not ban out the Wisp now, just to make sure? Pi does play a really good Wisp, and they can just put Misery on the Tusk again.
They could also Brood.
It's not a bad idea.
Huskar?
Huskar I don't like versus their heroes. The Dazzle's under a lot of pressure from the Night Stalker, won't be able to get timely graves. A lot of physical from Juggernaut and Ember Spirit, and the Decay's very good versus him in the early game.
Good call.
Okay, never mind.
Brood cancer.
What else can Team Secret go for then?
Perfect's in the turn of Envy Hero. The other four that he's played here in Frankfurt are Spectre, Huskar, Queen of Pain, and Wraith King.
I think the Tiny needs to be his hero.
You think?
It's hard to pick a Wisp up in this scenario because if you're running like Wisp Tiny mid, you'll just have an undying support.
It's good in the sense that it can really negate a lot of Nightstalker's gain potential later on in the game, and you can quickly outnumber them the same way. There's not a lot of mobility in an undying.
I think Wisp is their best option, but I believe Evil Geniuses have it decently well countered. Vision game is really important.
Is there anything that they're going to combo with the Tiny? I've seen like weird things like Tiny Centaur or something before, but...
Oh, let's go with it.
So we go back to the Red Tiny for position.
An Avengeful Spirit finish. Of the draft, EG versus Team Secret, game 3 for all the marbles. Let's go back to the commentary team with Toby Wong.
Thanks a lot. Yes, it's time to get back underway to decide, find out who will be going through into the grand final for the first ever Dota 2 Major live here in Frankfurt. Sindarin, who will it be? Judging off the draft, show us the wisdom.
I think it's really hard to say. I agree with the Huskar pick from Team Secret, actually. I'm not 100% in agreement with Merlini that the counters EG have are strong enough, and that's why they last pick Eventual Spirit. It seemed like they were already prepared. The Huskar is coming, when they get it, we just snap pick Venge. They didn't even really take any time to think about it. So that's gonna help them out a lot with getting that extra physical damage in and dealing with it. So with that in mind, probably, I could say a slight advantage to Evil Geniuses under the condition that they don't lose too much in the lanes. Huskar is pretty difficult to deal with in lane for most of their heroes.
Yeah, that he is. And you start to wonder too how EG approach this laning phase. So you talk about the Burning Spears. Can they, in fact, keep Eternal Envy, this Huskar, shut down enough? That's the big question as we get underway for EG versus Secret. Game number 3. To decide who will be able to not have to play through two series tomorrow, because that is the downside. There's even another series coming up later tonight. OG going up against EHOME. The loser of this series will have to play through the winner of that one and then get the rematch, potentially, in the grand final of Secret EG.
And just before we get too far into this game, I want to mention Knoxville wrote to me, Secret won the coin toss. And they actually picked Radiant in this game. So EG took first pick. That to me shows that Secret might have already at that point considered the Pylai die Tiny to secure the mid lane, which they can only do this way. At least to my knowledge, you might not be able to do that on Dire, or it doesn't have the same impact.
Well, you got a closer tree line on the Radiant side, so you can just walk up through that.
It's definitely easier on the Radiant. And in addition to that, I think Secret might also just prioritize the better laning over the Roshan advantage that Dire do have. So in this series so far, I do believe where EG or Secret were on Dire in both games until this one, right? Yes,
correct.
They were.
Yes.
And both times they struggled with the laning phase. They actually lost the lanes pretty significantly both times. So this might be their way to try to repair that.
Well, EG have one of the greatest laners in the game. It's going to be the Undying. Already having a bit of a battle with Puppy as they just try and zone them out. The runes have already been taken, one going to the Ember, one going to the Windranger. It's no surprise there, but Fear is really He's pushing this issue against Puppy. Puppy doesn't have a lot of life to work with, but it's the melee versus the ranged battle. And PPD is the only ranged hero on all of EG. And he's a vengeful spirit. He's also coming for Kurius to die. Pylai Dai is watching, and he's using the toss to throw the Hellbear to do the pull. PPD will watch this happen right in front of his eyes and then drag the creep wave back up again. He's trying to make sure that Samael doesn't lose out in this mid lane, which is so easy to do when you do creep pulling like this.
And this is one thing that's incredible about having the Undying for EG, is that they can't contest this guy with their two supports. Level 1, Fear can zone Puppy until the end of time here, and he actually doesn't really care too much, as long as the other lanes are going fine. Arteezy bottom, one-on-one matchup with Tusk on Juggernaut should be perfectly fine. The top lane, Universe against Envy, that's the harder one, but Universe is going very aggressive. Just look at him actually run Envy down, and that's because support is arriving from Peter.
With the stun, they might have enough. Universe, Void in 1 second time, they're not gonna come under the tower. The TP support started, but it was not completed.
Very,
Eternal
very
Envy
close.
Will survive. They're doing the stack again. In fact, Pylai Dai, not a healthy man as Samael comes to contest it. Puppy as well as Pylai Dai think about another run, but they don't have a toss available. So Samael will come back to the lane. After PBD stopped it the first time, you just saw it happen again. Like, Pylai Dai walked down, tossed one of the Hellbears, and he pulled the creep wave back down again. This was meant to be stopped by changing the way the creep camps work, but...
You know... Dota is a mysterious game. There's always something new you can do.
What we're what now? 9 years in, you're still finding new and different ways to manipulate the map to your advantage. And we're not even changing the map.
And the difference
top
about
lane,
this is
Envy going rather deep there on Universe. The TP support's not coming in. PPD also not in a position to wrap around, but he'll find Puppy. As Puppy will have to retreat back into the river. PPD, however, may be in a little bit of trouble as Eternal Envy moves up instantly on the stun, but you do have that poison touch. Combining it with the Burning Spears, it might be difficult for PPD to survive. Cop a lot of damage, and with no consumables on him. In fact, Universe is also down to one Tango. They don't have a lot of regeneration for EG on this safe lane.
I'm still very impressed with how Universe has been managing to play this lane so far. Being tied on farm with Huskar in what was essentially a one-on-one lane for the first 2 minutes is already impressive. Huskar is known to just absolutely dominate melee heroes. But Universe knows the limits of this hero and how he can pressure him very early on. And now you're seeing what will happen eventually. But Envy needs to be careful not to get a little bit too overconfident here.
Samael keeps hunting for his creeps. He keeps trying to find it, but Pylai continues to throw out creep after creep and just drag it back, getting easy levels onto the Tiny and denying the levels for Samael. So you're looking at almost a full level advantage coming the way of Weeha. You're looking at 16-2 up against 10-3, so Samael's doing a pretty damn good job for CS, but some of those creeps he picked up were also inside the jungle.
Well, good harassment being put out here by Samael. His flame guard will end now, so can't keep up the pressure. We'll force out the healing salve, most likely from Weeha, unless he very much wants to hold on to that, in which case he could just power shot and bottle a couple of times. Oh, there we go.
There is
but Misery just really getting pounded in this bottom lane. Like,
yeah,
Fear is not letting him have anything.
That's kind of the big thing for EG. Like, you could talk about Samael missing out in a little bit. You're getting an even trade coming out for Universe, who's now going to rotate as we hit the 4 minute mark. But Arteezy is leading the CS board. He's a little bit behind on the last hits as far as money goes, because Windranger is just having a better time in mid. But Arteezy's got 13 denies this bottom lane. So he's choking the lane out. And Misery keeps getting decayed, so he's not finding the levels. You're not finding that early farm on the Tuskar, and you're definitely not finding that early Walrus punch on him.
And he's a key hero, you know. This draft from Secret, of course, the idea going into the mid game is, since they are playing the Tiny as a support, the heroes that need to deal the damage will be the Huskar and the Windranger. They have a lot of defensive tools. One of them is, of course, that Snowball. Misery hasn't skilled just yet, but if he's very low level, he'll be sacrificing his own life every single time he tries to save someone just because he's such an easy kill.
Mm-hmm.
So you gotta be a bit careful. So far, the lane stage is very even, though. It favors Secret slightly on the economy.
Samael? He's really low in front of Weeha. Weeha's still got Windrun too, so if he wants to force the issue, well, he can't. Samael's walking around with an invis rune, but Pylai is waiting. He just wants to toss Weeha forward. Weeha, Windrun forward with the focus fire. Samael has to take charge, but here comes your toss. Not enough damage! Samael dropping down to 36. Meanwhile, up on top lane, that Shallow Grave keeping Puppy alive. PPD, he's got three Burning Spears on him, plus Poison Touch. He's regenerating back in the fountain, and he will end up surviving. But a very good time for him to TP out and back to safety.
Once again, a very, very close exchange here. Nobody dying, so still 6 minutes soon. No first blood being claimed. I think, realistically, it will be coming out from this bottom lane. Misery is playing very safe, knowing that Arteezy and Fear combined can probably kill him. But at some point, he's got to try to go for some CS or experience and could, of course, get caught out by the Nightstalker. But Universe showing in the top lane will probably make him feel a little bit safer. And, and toward that mid lane, as you said, Weehi's getting the better exchange. Now, what does Samael do? There are no stacks for him actually being set up here by EG. Why am I moving forward?
All I can do is just get a little bit of farm. Might also, by disappearing from the map here, he might make Secret think they have to commit to come into the Dire jungle. It's just going to waste time looking for stacks. In fact, Pylai die, he'll rotate up to the top. Universe has no vision of this. There's the Radiant Observer on the side, and Universe could actually be in a world of hurt. With that Avalanche and the Toss, it's not burning spears. Universe will die, and First Blood will be spilt by Eternal Envy. They might go for a trade-off on bottom lane, however, with that Tombstone committed, Omnislash is available, and Misery stunned up into the spin, and Misery, he'll snowball to protect himself for now, actually going all the way up to PPD, but he still needs that talent. Gets a... Okay, a decent hit.
Oh,
he doesn't switch the aggro! That actually allows Misery to get the money for the death of the Juggernaut.
And he really thought he could switch that aggro. There were two ways for Arteezy to play that situation. Either he drops the healing ward immediately and tries to stay alive with that and tanks the tower, which was maybe not going to be enough, or he flat out just Omnislashes Misery earlier when the stun from PPD comes in and they kill him instantly. But being able to greet it there, wanting to hold the cooldown is understandable. Of course, it does backfire in that situation.
Well, EG, even if it does backfire, they're going to try and look for more. Samael just used the Searing Chain, so Weeha might feel a little bit more confident in this mid lane. The Radiant Observer, what they've got in mid, doesn't actually see PPD in the tree line. And PPD plants his own fresh Observer Ward, so he understands that Weeha's got no real support behind him. Universe inching forward, and Weeha, he's still got that Haste Rune, so them, like, getting caught out is almost impossible for him. They have to wait till that Haste Rune expends. And meanwhile, Team Secret now pushing a lot of damage into that tier 1 tower on top.
Yep, Eternal Envy. Almost got the armlet, so we'll be sub 10. Generally see these armlets from Huskars. If you have free farm, you get it extremely early, and it is just the item for the hero.
PPD is now visible, so Weeha is just playing very defensive. The bottom lane Tombstone's been dropped, but Misery, okay, Arteezy, what have you got? Not enough mana. He's got the Mango, so he could turn for an Omnislash if Secret decide to chase. But they don't instead. They just try and get rid of that Tombstone. Fear going to make it difficult with Sol Ripper in the case. Now Omnislash Puppy. Shadow Grave will protect him, but Misery still ends up dying Puppy. He's one attack away from death. Instead, he Shadow Waves up, gets rid of the Healing Ward. Arteezy looking for an opening. Eternal Envy going on Fear, but Fear TP's himself out. But Arteezy's in no man's land. PPD is in the neighborhood, and now they toss the Huskar forward. Eternal Envy, how much support is there? A lot. Samael arrives, double damage in hand. Eternal Envy will die. Arteezy, he's still got four burning spears on him. The one, he's actually got the survivability because of the spin, so there's no damage coming. In fact, Samael just burning through Pylai Dai, moving to Weeha. Wind runs out. Magic Missile will connect, buying the time for Samael to attack, and the perfect shards from Misery with the snowball out. He can keep Samael controlled for now. Weeha, more mana is available. He's got Power Shot. Shackle in 1 second time. Samael has a lot of trees. And in fact, he gets latched to one of them with the Power Shot. They could find this damage. And in fact, they just do it through the basic attack. Shards included. And Team Secret get a big answer to EG's aggression.
Nice attempt there from the Ember to try and catch the Windrunner, realizing, okay, I've got double damage. She used her Windrun, but the Shackles again. Weeha just seems to never miss these Shackle shots. And of course, the rotation from Misery absolutely necessary to keep him alive there. Perfect shards, snowball. This is some really high-level play from both teams. EG, in this instance, getting the better exchange, of course, claiming the tower. Now the question is how much they can get out of
bottom.
This armlet on a turn.
That
end.
Spirit was still down there. Samael jumped down to it. He's got the Searing Chains available and a bias time for Arteezy to come in close. The snowball's going in Arteezy, so he just spins, ensures the damage on Misery. And Misery buys his stress before death. Also look towards the mid lane. PPD starts with the Wave of Terror. Still decent armor on Huskar, but they drop the Tombstone. Fear is going to have to self Sol Rip to stay alive. The Tombstone's down, but Eternal Envy, Shadow Graves allowing him to fight. He'll actually armor toggle back up again and keep attacking him. PPD has to back out of here. He's already used his one charges, he's got three Burning Spear charges on him, barely surviving on 38 life. And Team Secret showing their superior team fight. That Undying Tombstone did not last long.
It's very difficult for them to fight the Huskar. without Juggernaut being there. It's just, the Ember Spirit doesn't have single target physical. He doesn't even have Sleight of Fist yet. So how is he even going to get in on Eternal Envy without just taking massive Burning Spirit damage and losing his Flame Guard? And they have Dazzle backing him up. Nightstalker, it was daytime there, so couldn't really do so much universe. Difficult situation, and Fear going in to plant the Tombstone. Understandable that he thought they could get away with that, but Secret stood strong. This is a very, very close game, but Secret pull back their 1,000 gold lead.
Secret have an opening. Misery's got the vision advantage. EG, they don't see anything up that hill, so Fear comes in. The shards don't perfectly block it, but with the Husker being tossed in, they just beat in. And the Shackle, it latches from Weeha, holding universal position, but Samael, it's a big burn coming out from him. The side of Fist is nothing else. He doesn't actually have it. He has to pull back, but six burning spear charges. Samael is dead. There's no way to survive. EG lose three. The only thing lost from Team Secret was the Tiny. Eternal Envy was soaking up all of the deeps of EG. No mana again for the Juggernaut, so there was no Omnislash for RTG to bring. And PB still without swap, he can't save the initiated targets.
Those ice shards for Misery, crucial for landing them one or two bonus kills there. And EG have to get better timing to engage like this. The Samael comes in, deals a lot of damage. Then when he has to go out, Arteezy comes in with his Blade Fury, deals a lot of damage, but it's not layered correctly, so Secret can easily keep their heroes alive with one charges, with the Dazzle, Heal, and of course the Grave. And it all started by Fear being initiated on, and the Tombstone being focused by Secret. Huskar is incredible at bringing down the Tombstone. It's not about health, it's about number of attacks since the change. And right now the Tombstone takes 5 hits to destroy. Huskar can do that within 2 seconds on his own.
The Observer Ward's down, Eternal Envy. He's gonna lose that double damage rune, and Samael, well, Envy doesn't care. He just attacks. The Spirit will bring Samael back out to safety. Then again, he's got 4 Burning Spear charges on him. He's dying. He is actually bottle charges up. He's got 1 charge left. He'll survive.
Trying to greed that out as much as possible. Started doing some math when he saw how much health he was losing.
He's like, doing math. He just opened up the bottle and tried to pour it on top of himself. This water beats fire somehow.
Now Arteezy with the split push top, getting some decent damage in here. Does of course know that he can always just spin TP apart from... There are 2 counters. There's the ultimate from Tusk, the Walrus Punch,
universe,
or the toss.
Universe, not the dream. Snowball in, punch up, and Universe is down. Wind Ranger, a very easy kill for Weeha. I also want to flag the choice of Eternal Envy. Could dominate any creep on the map. What do you take? You take a ghost. That is what they're split pushing with on the bottom lane right now.
That's nice. It's got 1400 health and it's slow.
It's the power choice. When you're running up against 4 melee heroes, why not? Toss. Arteezy instantly goes for the spin. Eternal Envy still taking considerable damage from this, but he doesn't really care. The more damage he takes, the stronger it gets. Arteezy, Misery punches him down, and now Samael. He can't stand the fight. 5 spear charges on him once again. The Flame Guard won't protect enough.
Oh, Secret needs to get the hell out of there. This Tombstone is causing a lot of problems.
Well, that Sigil is still down for now. Samael, the toss forward. That one creep ended up getting the kill. The melee doing work. So it's 2-for-1, Secret. Now lose Misery in the middle lane. So 2-for-2 trade-off. Wave of Terror reveals the fact Eternal Envy is retreating out. And EG, an even trade for them right now is a good trade.
Secret should be very happy right there that Arteezy didn't have buyback. They would have lost so many heroes. I think they were slowed down by the Tombstone. They don't have any easy way of disengaging it apart from destroying it, but it was very well placed by Fear on the backline while still spawning 2 or 3 zombies on every hero. So they got out of that more or less intact on those 3 other heroes, and maybe they can put a bit of pressure on bottom. And
well, Samael comes in. They've already used their toss. And Samael flags the fact they are attacking bottom, and EG are coming out to fight them. There are 3-man smoke up, Omnislash is up. This time PPD will have swap available as well. We have a level 4 Tombstone on Puppy. He's the man in the front lines. Ember Spirit jumping forward. There goes your magic missile on Puppy. Eternal Envy jumping in pretty deep. The swap pulling him back in range of the tier 1 tower with a void. They can hold him in position. There is no armlet toggle. EG move forward. Puppy, the TPs are coming. Is there a stun on Pilot Eye? No, there is not. So EG, the smoke gang successful. They bring down both Eternal Envy as well as Puppy.
And Puppy was just not in range to Grave Envy. So he's like, okay, in this situation, I can't do anything else than Grave myself to just try and get an extra heal out. Oh, nice damage.
Oh, he pushes Fear up. Fear has to TP out.
Yep.
He's stuck on the hillside, so he'll TP down to the tier 1 tower. And this just stops the push from the Roshan attempt from EG. Arteezy's being chased by Misery as well as Weeha. And he knows it with the shards just appearing in mid lane. But they just retreat. They don't risk EG.
That was a really good hold here from Secret. They realize the damage output they have should be enough to prevent EG from going for the Roshan. Did work on that occasion, but should another teamfight go EG's way similar to before, I think they'll have the Roshan the next time around.
PPD, Shackle, skewer Shackles onto PPD. And with the power shot again, Weehigh able to pick up a very simple kill.
Has he missed the Shackle yet this game? I don't think so.
No, not to my memory. But I only remember the good things of life. 11 to 10, Secret. Smoke up now in the mid. They use a Wind Ranger illusion as bait, but no one from EG is taking it. Instead,
They're hoping that Sumail jumps his spirit, I think, after taking this camp, that he gets scared of getting ganked in the Radiant Jungle.
They only just see the spirit now, but you're right. They camp around it. Pylai die. Universe actually breaks the smoke there. And Arteezy's in the neighborhood, so Ember Spirit could come in. And EG, they're trapped between the Tier 1, Tier 2 town. In fact, Misery's already taking damage.
EG actually had a really good positional advantage there until that sentry got that observer got dewarded by Puppy. Very important they take that down, because... Well, might
EG
not
smoke.
Be. Right, here we go.
They're right in front of Team Secret. They want to fight this. The power shot from Weehaw won't reveal anything. In fact, all it does is make a path down the right side, and EG... They'll let the T1 tower go. There is fortification. They'll trigger it because it's going to come back off cooldown anyway once the T1 tower drops. Not easy. Now moves forward. Attacks, gets a little bit of vision. EG, they are coming down. The Sigil will time out. And Team Secret are backing up. Ghosty.
Oh, triggered the healing ward there. That's a really big tool expended here by Arteezy. If the fight breaks out in about 20 seconds now. Darkness. Oh, never mind. That was just a void. Sounded a little more dramatic. Of course, Universe is going to hold on to that until they want to engage.
That'll be a big bait. Sumail having catapults tossed at him. Well, at least they're not getting doomed today. But that tier 1 tower will belong to Eternal Envy now.
Took them a while to get it, but they didn't really pay for it. EG weren't split pushing very much.
I think EG really wanted a fight, but they understand if they take the fight, it's so unfavorable. Now, Huskar being tossed in, the stun is on Eternal Envy, and Fear is just watching it. That snowball is in very deep. Misery chasing out. The tombstone will drop. It's very deep, but it's the attack from Arteezy with that Blade Fury. Pylai Dai is down Eternal Envy. Where is your damage now? With the Shackle is holding him together. EG, Envy can do the damage. The Shallow Grave will let him fight even more. Gossip taking damage from the tower, the armor toggle, and he's still got 10 stick charges. Will definitely help Universe. With a void, he only throws it on Misery and Envy jumps back into the fight, but they're ready to go. Soul Ripper's available.
Oh, the
and
snowball!
Envy, well, the snowball protects him. Envy gets the armor toggle back up. Universe, he's dropping low. They do bring down Eternal Envy, but what a cost. Arteezy is dying and will not be able to survive the shards and power shot. Team Secret, wipe evil geniuses from the face of the tier 2.
This game, this is every Husker game for you right there. It's all about baiting and assessing how much damage you can output. The Omnislash was expended early and didn't get to do very much damage onto Envy, and then Secret, no, okay, we can keep kiting them. We just need a good grave from Puppy, and we need a good snowball from Misery. They got both of them out, dealt a lot of, delayed it so long.
Oh, PPD.
But they got to deal enough damage.
Thought for a moment he's been looking for that swap, but then I realized it was Fear TPing him. They don't have any more real controls there, apart from the magic missile, but that wouldn't be enough.
Get the deny here on the tower. And Fear needs a better tombstone than that one, I think.
It was a long way back. It was actually on the, yeah. I think he meant to put it on top of the hill.
Well, I get what he was thinking, because the snowball came in so deep, as you saw, Misery just ended up outside the tier 3 and probably thought he was in a horrible spot. But the only thing that tombstone did was spawn a couple of zombies on Misery, and he still got to disengage. So then they didn't have it for the following fight. And it needs to be placed in such a way that it spawns zombies on 3 or 4 heroes and outside the reach of Huskar. Ideally, they wait until after Huskar jumps in with his life break, and then they place it away from him, because then he has no way of closing the gap and getting in and doing the damage. That was what kept EG in the previous teamfight, was the tombstone. This time they just didn't have it.
So Team Secret looking for another fight already. Four-man group up onto the T1 tower. They'll blow their smoke. Well, the power shot has revealed their position. That's their last smoke, but they got another one up in 1 minute and 20 seconds anyway. So they'll be ready to fight again. Universe is probably the most exposed man of them all. And with that movement speed, though, he can run himself out of here. PPD's in the neighborhood, so he can
Shackle
swap
missed.
Universe. Shackle will not be able to connect, and Universe so low. PPD, that's actually kept the swap. He got nudged by the shards and decided not to try and save the Night Stalker.
I think he wanted to create enough space between himself and Universe so the Shackle wouldn't land. And then when he got tossed by the Tiny, he couldn't click the swap in time onto that Night Stalker.
Well, secret.
So even though the Shackle misses, it was actually necessary to get the kill.
Not so sure about this. They're right underneath the Dire Observer Ward. So EG, they will definitely be aware of this. They smoke underneath the Radiant Observer Ward, so Secret won't be aware they're here. Buyback comes from the Nightstalker. Now the Tombstone's on the hillside, but they've got the Observer Ward on the, also on that high point, but they jump in. Side of Fist goes through. Radiant, they brought down Roshan, and they got the Aegis Maul on the hands of Eternal Envy, so they're going to kill Tasker twice over. That's going to be a hard task, especially when Arteezy is almost dead. In fact, he is dead. A one-for-one trade-off. Envy's running away from the undead horde. Pylodai's not a healthy man as Envy getting stunned up. The Shackle won't latch on Samael. Pylodai slowly being brought down by Universe. Need a little bit more damage. The side effects from Samael will do that work, but Eternal Envy, the sole survivor for Team Secret. Armlet toggling, Universe burning, and in fact burnt down to the searing chain. Samael's in the tree line. Now he's finally got a spirit to work with. Jumps up and away from Envy, who's too far away to get that life break off.
It's always scary going Roshan against an Undying this early in the game. And this Tombstone placement from Fear, this time around it was great. He placed it in there because he probably wasn't sure if Secret had a ward at the exact spot they have one themselves, which is probably the best spot around the Rosh Pit in most cases to place it right on top of that Observer they have right there.
He threw it
and they started attacking it, but they couldn't bring it down. He was ready with the Soul Rip as well to save it.
Well, they had too many problems. EG just entered the pit. They couldn't just stand there trying to attack a Tombstone when you've got a Juggernaut as well as an Ember Spirit ripping you apart. Mid-tier 1 tower, Catapult will not be able to get it, so the Nile will come the way of the Tiny.
That's a lot of TPs from Secret into that mid lane.
They must be planning on something else. They don't see the Tombstone, however, so they can't even kill it and get the extra cash. It finishes its full duration.
All of these TPs going into what the mid lane allows EG to split push a bit and feeling safe, but Secret obviously just want to take the fight to them. They have the Aegis. I think the right call from EG right now is sacrifice this tower. It's a bad position for you to put your Tombstone in. It's much more accessible for Secret here than it would be on their own high ground, and they're not going to try. They would probably also have been there too late. Get some split push, get some farm. RT.
Where is that? He's creep skipping.
Cut the wave here.
So he's just making sure that this push from Team Secret can't go any further unless Secret properly commit to it. It's not just to sit back and slowly chip out the tower. Eternal Envy now completes up a new item too. He's now got that Heaven's Halberd coming into the fight.
Oh, this is taking EG a while to get in position for. They're losing their tier 3 before it even starts.
They don't even have Juggernaut back. He can TP, but Arteezy again will cut the creep wave. So without that secondary creep wave, they don't have anything. In fact, they should be careful with a courier. Samael is going to spirit himself away.
Well, they do have a dominated range creep.
Oh. But they're fighting backdoor regen.
Yeah, that's not happening.
Yeah, they have to stop just because of the creep cut.
I'm actually surprised Arteezy went back. He should have kept doing that until any sort of response was shown from Secret.
Either that or he just understands that cutting two creep waves is going to be a Secret fallback. That the backdoor regen would kick in. EG also, because they're observed what they planted in the lane, they scouted out the fact that the Blink Dagger is now over on Weeha. They'll be prepared for the Windranger jumping. Now they also don't want to fight. Like, you've still got an Aegis the Immortal on the Husker.
Oh, some mail.
He's got to rem it up.
He's got to get out of there immediately. Closing in on the Battle Fury, this is the thing EG will need. Looking at this draft and the way the game is going to develop, Secret are kind of on a timer here. The Huskar will not keep being this ridiculous 20 minutes from now. They need to start taking barracks. EG can sacrifice one lane, but not two.
And Eternal Envy stands on the front lines. The Weave, his armor is over 30 at the moment. Standing on the front lines, and Weeha blinks forward, doesn't actually go for the Shackle, just baits out Arteezy's spin. Well, Eternal Envy still taking a lot. Now your Shackle, Peepity swapping Samael out, but the damage is too much of the focus fine. No! He spears up, he jumps away, he'll survive for this. Peepity even stick charges are letting him stand this fight. And Fear with the Decay and Soul Rift. There's so much damage. Omnislash will finally get a kill. It's gonna be misery. The Shackle goes again. Arteezy controlled for now. Focus fire going to work, but the damage has just stopped being impactful here from Team Secret. Envy, the Aegis Immortal will shatter on him. Pylodai, the Avalanche will buy him space with the Spirit jump down.
Pyre's gonna die as well. Gets the Searing Chains off and Eternal Envy. He's done for the moment. He can armor the toggle with his stick charges as well. How much can they do? Not enough. Envy's down for the count. EG, they did, not only do they defend high ground, they do it without having to expend any buybacks. They work through an Aegis to the Immortal, and the Melee Rack survives.
Great Tombstone and Tombstone? Great Tombstone and Soul Rift from Fear in that situation. The swap coming out from PPD as early as it did allowed them to keep the Samael alive, and then the Soul Rift healed him about 400, I think, in that instance. Mm-hmm. So he was able to re-engage, and Secret committed quite a bit to that. Even though their Shackle shots were very good, they were still in a pretty bad position overall, and the Tombstone just started stacking up. EG do a lot of damage over time, and the Huskar just couldn't find the kills. Notice as well how EG approached that fight. They went in on the Tuskar. They didn't try to kill off the Huskar as fast as they could, because they know he has Aegis, and the investment there, the risk-reward ratio is awful. Kill the other heroes. The less you damage Huskar, the less he does to you. So they need to avoid him and kill the others first, and then they dealt with him later. Surprising how fast he died the first time, actually, and they took the Aegis away. But they were just focusing other heroes.
Yep. And also that long duration as well. You don't attack the Huskar, but you keep taking his strength away. Fear was sitting in the back of that fight, throwing up multiple decays throughout the entire engagement.
I think we might see Fear go for an Aghanim's over Greaves here. There's nothing very valuable. Never mind, he's going Greaves. But there's nothing really valuable to remove with the Greaves. Of course, the lower cooldown is really good. But there's no like silence he can purge. There's no snares or anything.
Does he get rid of the spears?
No.
Okay. Then, so, yeah, that's not great.
It's still great. Of course, the armor when your allies drop low, the aura from these Greaves is incredible. But I was just thinking, the way Secret approach base sieging takes quite a bit of time, and you get a couple of decays up on that Undying, and it's more so about the strength the enemy loses than what you gain. So he could have gone for it, but maybe the build-up would take too long. He's focusing on what's good right now, because they still know that in this game they will be stronger if they just survive long enough.
I'm not certain if this was a misclick from PPD, but he blew a one-man smoke while being inside the fountain. And they don't have another smoke for another 2 minutes. So it's kind of a costly time for him. Maybe he's just trying to keep himself secret behind the core. But it could have also blown the chance for EG to have a big five-man smoke up. Team Secret, on the other hand, they're grouping up once again. They're not walking around with smoke, but they start a prep weave. Expecting EG to try and fight them. Smell's hovering around in an invis rune. They're not doing it. Arteezy's just stealing the Ancients at the moment, and they'll just get themselves straight back.
And looks like Arteezy's going for a BKB again here. I don't think this is going to be something like a Sanjin Yasha. It's way too late for it.
Yeah.
And that's going to, of course, the problem that EG faced in that last fight was it would have been a very one-sided fight if not for those, like, three, again, Shackle shots that Weehaw was landing. So if they can BKB to prevent themselves from taking damage from that, Avalanche Toss combo is going to be useless. The Tusk doesn't have the same impact.
It also lets him attack. It won't let him attack it directly into the Heaven's Halberd, but if he gets disarmed,
that's a good point.
There's ways to get out of that. They'll still need to work into the Monkey King bars. So we've looked at the Daedalus builds coming out from Envy earlier on. Arteezy, is he gonna go? No, he doesn't have a Blink Dagger. He can't go for Courier Snipe.
I agree. I think MKBs as the next item for both him and the Ember will almost secure EG the victory. Actually, in this game, with Secret having two cores that are so dependent on their evasion, and of course, I feel like not scaling as well as Juggernaut plus the Ember into the late game, even with an Ice Stalker with Midas, he can also become a core later on. Secret just won't have the response for that.
Oh, middle lane, good, this shackle is troublesome. Samael, the damage is enough. Pilot Eye throwing in an extra Avalanche just for insurance. Samael does have buyback, so EG are capable of defending with him, but if Secret force that, that's still a good thing. You talk about the ability to get those Monkey King bars, you need the money for it. You need a space to farm it, too. So they back up. Arteezy. It's not decision time yet. He doesn't have enough money to buy the full monkey, the full BKB.
And I think you're safe buyback at this point anyway. This is the kind of game that can end in one push if you mess up.
Arteezy, Shards, always locked in. The spin's already expended. He'll have to go into the Omnislash if he's going to survive. They punch him, and now Arteezy is down. Fear tried to help out by triggering the Greaves. The only upside for EG is the pressure, which is being applied currently on bottom lane, but that's a tier 2 tower. Secret taking out a Rax will be definitely worth the trade.
He has to buy back.
He does. The Ember's alive again, the fortification. Protects the range Rax. And Envy sitting on the front lines, they swap him in. The Ember Spirit gets Searing Chains off here, instantly into the ulti, and there's your buyback coming in from the Juggernaut. There's no... Okay, now the creep wave will arrive. The Glimmer Cape allowing Huskar just to back up a little bit further. Side of Fist, Searing Chains catches out Pylaidai, as well as Weeha. The Soul Rebellion doing a lot of damage to Weeha.
I think EG are really frustrated with this. They used a buyback, but EG, or Secret, just completely disengaged. They know Tombstone was expended as well, so these are some key cooldowns that EG don't have right now.
Have to wait 30 seconds until you get Fierce Tombstone back.
That's the Ranger X, I think.
Well, Envy, still standing in the front line. Shackle won't latch. Weeha's just fishing right now. PPD swaps off cooldown in 5 seconds time. And with Envy standing this close to the front lines, they can drag him back underneath that tier, underneath the tier 4 towers. And they kind of need something. Samael, he could fist a chain over on the Huskar. But if they swap PPD in, he dies almost instantly. So EG come out, they do have that unobstructed vision because of the Aghanim Scepter. We're still within night time for another 4 hours of Dota time. And the Shackle, oh, they found Fear. That's a big one. The swap from PPD, bringing Fear to safety. The Omnislash going on Eternal Envy, but the Glimmer Cape, they don't find another target effect. Arteezy bounces up the hill, and now with the spin, he's going to have no more immunity available. The Snowball comes forward. They're going to burn him out. Arteezy locked in the Icy Shards. Misery is still dying at the same time, and Fear doing serious work with his Decay, allowing Samael to burn him out, but Eternal Envy still surviving. Can they kill him? The Armlet Toggle, he's glimmering up, but they bring him down. Weeha's on the run, but Samael gets a triple kill. The buyback had to come out from the Ember Spirit, but they get the triple kill and they'll move for Roshan.
I really don't think that buyback had to come out. Unless they get the Roshan, that was not worth it for Samael, but it looks like it is the call here.
Yep.
They should have been able to kill the Windranger without that. He just basically bought back into one slide of Fist and Knivestalk was already running after the Windranger, but the play call here is buyback, secure the Rosh, get yourself the Aegis. And EG again. Yes. These fights are so much just about kiting and baiting out important cooldowns for both teams. Arteezy's Omnislash wasn't really that great. He only hit into the Huskar, but it's more about the response that it triggers and how it allows Samael to just get multiple slides of Fist off. And that's, of course, something we haven't talked about so much. In these clustered fights, Huskar actually takes quite a bit of damage from the pure damage from the cleave.
I'm still waiting to see how long it takes for Fear to finish this Aghanim Scepter. It's the item which he normally rushes on this Undying, but when Secret keep clustering like this, like there's four heroes standing on top of each other, taking these fights, Tuskar snowballs in, the Shans lock everyone into this big clustered area every time.
Aghanim's will be...
It's gonna be brutal.
Godlike this game.
Yep.
That's why I was thinking he was gonna get it over Greaves, but I think the Greaves have paid off. Simply when you look at these fights, the heroes start getting so low. Focus Fire deals pretty insignificant damage when your heroes start getting 15 armor when they drop low. So someone has to deal the finishing move, and who is it really? No one on Secret just yet has these big crits up that can just finish the job. He is getting there with Weeha, but it's still taking a while, and by that time the axe might be up.
Yeah, and by that time you're also gonna have that bigger damage coming into EG's line. At this point, Team Secret do have the top two net worth heroes on the field, and that's the Huskar as well as the Windranger. But the next four right behind it is Juggernaut, it's Nightstalker, it's Ember Spirit, it's the Undying. In fact, the Undying above that, the Tuskar, by a good 2k. They're starting to get big items up,
oh, this
but
is...
we look for the Immortal Huskar.
This is a big item.
I'm wondering if it's still going to be enough. Like, what does, like, can EG find more control?
They need to kill the other heroes first at this point. This Satanic makes a very big difference.
Okay, here's a question for you. Is it worthwhile for Arteezy to go in for something like a Heaven's Halberd? One, for the evasion, and two, because you don't have a BKB Huskar to get that disarm while he's triggering Satanic.
He might be considering it. I'm very surprised he went for this over the BKB we were expecting, so it could very well be a Halberd. I don't think SNY is going to make that big of a difference right now. Halberd could be way, way better.
Well, he'll have the choice and a little bit of gold. For now, he's just trying to push out the bottom lane and then TP back when Team Secret fight. But the top lane's got really good momentum here for EG. Like, there's a couple of Windranger illusions trying to push it back. But it's good deeps at the back, and the Secret just smoked on top of a Dire Observer ward. So EG are fully aware of what Team Secret are up to, and they don't really care. Like, you just spin out, TP out the Juggernaut, get back to base, everyone's safe. The top lane's got momentum for you, so you're okay with this as well.
Oh, and he broke the smoke with his sleight of fist. The heroes obviously do get revealed because your hero is technically traveling there. So Samael finds out, and he's now got a Chrysalis, and more important, this fight, EG have Aegis. And it gives them way more ways of approaching the fight. They just send Sumail in first, try to, again, bait key cooldowns to try and get the Aegis off of him.
Mm-hmm.
And they still have Swaplin back up.
Surprise Team Secret are even looking to fight while this Aegis is up. All they gotta do is wait 2 minutes.
Well,
push out the
satanic
lanes, but EG, with this Observer Ward on the hillside, they see a hell of a lot. Eternal Envy might come in. He already gets Searing chained in. And Arteezy, he was considering the Omni Slash, already the Healing Ward triggered by EG.
Yeah, they have to back. There's a good aggressive weave as well. Three of their heroes are woven right now.
Fail out.
Considering how long these fights extend for, that is going to just get them butchered by the Windranger.
It's so big as well with the combination on the Huskar. Like, your damage is starting to arrive for EG, your physical damage. But when that weave kicks in, if they get an Assault Cuirass or some big armor item over on top of the Huskar, like, your physical damage is going to have a hard time cutting through him. Arteezy, by the way, has enough money to pick up this halberd if that's his choice. But as you said, you got to keep your buyback. And right now, like, you still have three buybacks on EG's side. That's actually on cooldown for Arteezy, but only for 50 seconds. It looks like Secret will successfully wait out this Aegis time. It's only got one minute, 50 seconds left on it. Like, that's all.
Bounty rune for the Vengeful Spirit. PPD unusually rich this game.
Well, he's looking for an opening. Avalanche toss. The Observer Ward just got planted down by a Secret. I just love this mirror timing of EG and Secret. So EG try and get Vision over on the Ancients as well as the mid lane. And Secret drop an Observer Ward down too. But Universe with a Gem and Aghanim Scepter, these Observer Wards, they just don't last.
And this is when it starts getting scary for Secret, because they are the ones who want to start putting pressure on the map. And if they lose all their vision and start hesitating to push out waves, EG will catch up on farm and just outscale them later on. So Secret will probably wait for the Aegis to expire, which should be happening any second now, I think. Yeah, it's just like 10 seconds away for Sumail.
Yep.
And then they might try for a play. Do they have any smokes, though? Because that's the way they can really approach this aggressively. Eight-minute cooldown on their smoke, and there's none on their heroes. It's...
They don't even have it on the courier. There's a Ghost Scepter coming out in the courier.
This is a tricky 10 minutes that Secret are approaching right now, where they have to find some sort of way of forcing out the lanes enough that they can take a fight. 8 minutes of farm for EG. They can't let that happen.
EG will just dodge him. Like, the Observer Ward's watching almost all of Secret's movements at the moment. That one they planted on the Dire, on the Radiant Ancients. Because it's obviously the place where Secret are going to be looking to find a lot of farm. So if this does turn into a farm game, they know about it. Now you got a Solar Crest over on PPD. You're getting a BKB workup for Universe. Sumail is close to picking up that full Daedalus. So the damage increase will rapidly come up. And now TZ's still walking around with a lot of money. He's got 3k gold on this Juggernaut at the moment. So a surplus of 1600 gold.
And I don't think this is going to work very well for Secret, by the way. They're rotating to top to push this wave out. It's a way harder assault angle than the one in mid. There's no tower. There's still the melee barracks that they really want to claim. But in the top lane, they will naturally be pretty clustered against Sumail, who can probably very easily get in. There's also more assault angles for the Night Stalker. That's incorrect. There's not more assault angles, but I just think from looking at EG's perspective, it's easier to get a good tombstone that covers the entire entrance. The entrance in the middle is wider.
Yep.
Most of the time, you will see Radiant lineups prefer to siege top over bottom. And that's, again, because of the way the lane is placed and what you can do defensively, it's easier to execute for EG and Secret. Yeah, well, they pushed out the wave the best they could. They're not in a position to get all the way to the base, and EG will just keep farming. And you're looking at this gold graph, and whenever Secret bunch up as five and just shove one lane and they get split pushed in two others, they're losing GPM effectively to EG.
It's not just the gold per minute. If you look at the experience, EG are continuously gaining almost every single fight. They're now down, they're up to 10,000 advantage over Team Secret.
Sanjin Yasha minute 39.
That is
surprising.
Like, I know in China we saw these 32 minute SMYs coming up a lot more, but yeah, that's the choice from Arteezy.
It's a good hybrid item, of course. Like, I'm not going to say this item isn't good on Juggernaut. I think it's exceptionally good on Juggernaut. But
it's just late.
It's just late, exactly. I'm not sure it was the best choice, but it still might just work. Just getting, if you're looking at how these fights are going, extra mobility, more stats, always good.
Well, at the moment, Team Secret adding a little bit of momentum to that bottom lane. I say a little bit. They're basically a double wave pushing in the bottom, while EG forcing out the top lane.
Radiance top tower. And Secret, they get this one lane push and they have to go back again. Same story. It's the Night Stalker's control. Now, we are going to reach daytime very soon. Should kick in about 6 seconds. Universe does have another darkness cast, but I think he's going to hold on to it just in case a fight breaks out.
Yep. There's no reason to take the risk.
He's just getting out of there.
Is it Universe now going for the SMY? It should be a halberd for him. But he's got the Sanj as well. 40 minutes in. That Demon Edge just picked up for some mail. He's got enough money he can buy up the full Daedalus if he so desires. But we also talked about the need for the Monkey King Bars to come the way of EG. So do you just keep it with the Chrysalis, get to your 3k, and then finish up the Monkey King Bar?
This is one of the games where, at this point, it might be a little bit tricky with the choice, since with how clustered the fights are and how many targets Samael finds, just the raw cleave damage from getting crits on one of the heroes without evasion could pose a really big threat to Secret Heroes, but I still think overall the MKB is most likely going to do more damage right now. So Chrysalis MKB would be my suggestion here.
Well, we thought it was late. It's the third latest SNY pickup on Juggernaut of all time. Very, very late.
That is late.
It is late. Hatizi venturing into the river. Normally, this is the line which is drawn between the two teams around this point of the game, where you only cross when you have reinforcements. Instead, he walks the line up to the top. Still so much more money he's picked up. With this Battle Fury, he farms so quickly, and he keeps expending his Blade Fury to push the lane safely and then just TP out.
Yeah, it is the Daedalus for Samael. No buyback, by the way. This is a high-risk play.
But it's the smoke time. Yeah.
This is what Secret have been waiting for a long time, the ability to try to go for Roche. This Courier is dead.
Well, the Courier might die. EG, they actually blow their smokes. The side of Fist Steering Chain catching Weehara Misery, forcing the BKB out from the Windranger. Eternal Envy standing on the front lines up against the spinning EE. Will it be enough? Arteezy keeps battling. Now the Omni Slash will go. The Tombstone has been brought down. Eternal Envy taking every Omni Slash. PBD swaps Arteezy back out of safety. And another Searing Chain from Samael, but they can't get close. The Shards are keeping them out. PPD, he will not survive, but that being the only casualty when Secret are fighting from up on the hill, EG should still be very happy with that.
It looked like Fear couldn't get in position to soul rip his tombstone, and Secret bringing down that tomb at the time they did, so important for them to get ahead in the fight. And again, Arteezy's Omni Slash, he can't Omni Slash into solo Huskar right now with a Satanic. It's just a wasted cooldown, more or less.
He took no damage, too.
Yeah.
Like, the Weaver, I think, was actually maxing out at that point. Yep. Like, there was no damage with the plate mail. There was actually, he had the plate mail before.
And it's also a big loss for EG to not get that Talisman of Evasion. That was actually the Halberd that Universe would have had there. And now they have to wait 2 minutes. They have to give over an Aegis.
Yeah.
I like the fact that Secret, so in most cases right now, you will give the Aegis to the Huskar and you will just use him as a siege engine, but first of all, there's a cheese, and Huskar has way more health to utilize with it. And secondly, he's not dying in the first place. To just put it on Weeha, Huskar, even without Aegis, when you have a Dazzle and backup like this, it's so difficult to deal with. I think EG have to concede these barracks and look to hold a second lane.
You really don't want to be forced into this. If you can at least clean up the creep wave.
Samael has buyback now. That's important.
He's got buyback, Tombstone is up. You're currently in darkness too, so Secret, they're a little bit blind going up that hill. I love how Puppy is carrying for Envy. They'll end up finishing the full assault Cura, so he hands the plate mail back, so I wasn't insane. He did actually have the plate mail during the fight. And Samael doing so much work. He's actually got, because he's got that buyback, he's cleaned up these creep waves, a little of extra money for him. But there's still no direct attack into the Windranger or the Huskar because of their evasion. So it's going to be such a hard defense for EG. But if they don't defend it, Team Secret will just keep coming. So all they can really do is just try and slide a fist the wave down. And that's why Envy moves aggressively forward, making it so Samael has to play further back. He doesn't have this Blink Dagger, so the slide a fist goes to work. Eternal Envy losing a little bit of life, Fear taking it with the Decay. And now they go for more. Slide a fist again, Weeha. Unable to find that opening with the Shackle Shot, but Envy just stands his ground. Still with the cheese, still with the Satanic, they swap him up. Can they get the chains with the control underneath the Tier 4 towers? Envy, he just turns on the armor, so much life. The Omni Slash actually chasing down Pylai Dai outside the basement. Eternal Envy, now he triggers the cheese. They keep the Tombstone alive. Weeha can't get rid of it, but he's killing off Fear a little bit further up as they snowball in. Universe out of this fight, but you've still got so much to fight with. The sign of Fist Searing Chains does take away a little bit of the life of Team Secret, and they have burned the Aegis, the Immortal of Weeha, then the cheese as well. They'll lose the melee racks, but because Team Secret have expended so much, they may not
be able to keep this fight going. In fact, they probably should not, as Arteezy spins forward. Eternal Envy wants to fight him with the punch. They actually bring him down. Buyback has to come out from the Juggernaut because they've already lost another. The Night Stalker's down with no Buyback. Team Secret, a big opportunity for them to take two lanes of racks. Zumail needs to keep this defense going. PPD has swap available. They look for the opening. No Omni Slash up. And Eternal Envy, Satanic's back off cooldown. Zumail, they start to tick through him. But the tier 3 tower is dropped. Weeha with the focus fire can just keep pumping it out. They'll get through the range racks as well. No Searing Chains, no mana for Zumail. He's not ready to fight. Arteezy's still not ready to go either. This melee racks will belong to Envy. They're just not ready. PPD could potentially swap into stun. Zumail comes back. Here it is. Eternal Envy. Isaiah, the shackle flies up. Only catching PPD. Eternal Envy finishes the racks and moves onto the captain of EG. PPD, the soul rip, keeps him alive a little bit longer. They buy time for Zumail to do his work. Misery as well as Pylai die. Pylai barely surviving as a spirit jump back. Zumail, he's so low. Weeha brings him down. The buyback has to come out. EG under siege. Arteezy surviving under his own tier 4 tower. But Team Secret, are you in too deep now? That's the big question. You've already taken two lanes of practice. They need to get back out. Zumail, try and take more. There's your jump with the spirit back out. Eternal Envy will not follow him. And Arteezy, Omni Slash back off cooldown. No Radiant Creep Wave. This could be big for him. That's level 3. This could easily be a double kill if he can just get close enough. Misery is the only one isolated. He wants Envy and Pylai die. The Radiant Creep Wave is rapidly approaching. And Arteezy, is he going to let it rip? Avoids the avalanche. Envy still here. Does he want to do it? Pylai dies now. But the Creep Wave has arrived. They isolate Pylai die on the sideline. He four starves up, but he'll die the Searing Chains, losing his Gem of True Sight. Is there a stun? No, there's not. Eternal Envy gets back out again. Team Secret. They've done the damage, and they get away with few casualties.
That cost EG so much. The moment they had forced out the cheese and the Aegis and only lost their middle racks, I think that's when you just calm down, you wait for bottom lane, and you try to fight there. But they kept running into Secret, trying to put as much pressure as possible, but they're so durable. And again, it was the thing that triggered the whole thing is a mistake Arteezy has made earlier in this game as well. He Blade Furious to try to damage the creep wave. Ice Shards don't care. Block him off, get the easy kill. That's what snowballed the whole thing in there for Secret. And now a 10... Wait, what?
It's
14,000 gold?
It's actually almost 16,000 right. When you take that into account. You look at the experience, it was a 12,000 advantage, and it's almost back in the way of Secret. They haven't led in the experience for just over 20 minutes. But that 5 from EG, as you said, they just kept running in. That's easy experience on wheels.
Arteezy has to stop trying to play for your waves down like that now. Of course, it is tempting to just do the damage and try to push them out so you have them out of the picture for if you want to Omni Slash later on. But this Ice Shard thing, I think that's the third time this game it happens for Arteezy. And this one was really, really costly and almost lost them the game right there.
Well, they may have lost it on momentum. EG battening down the hatch, a Secret. They just need one more lane of racks to force out the Megas. Roshan will probably be our next big point of contest. In 2.5 minutes, he could potentially be up.
Arteezy's close to the MKB. That's a big upgrade. But his main problem in these fights is still that he is not strong enough that he can just stand and hit. After the Omni Slash, most of the time he'll just have to spin disengage. If he gets caught by a Shackle Shot or an Avalanche Toss, he's almost gone immediately. And now he's 100 gold away from it and he can't get it yet. He's sending out the Courier, but there's actually a Radiant Observe Award. There's actually two Radiant Observe Awards on the spot.
Mm-hmm.
Getting ready to Misery. Go for a snipe.
There's your jump in. Goes after Arteezy. The Weave hitting aggressively on Arteezy. It's about a Weeha! You Shackle! The Swap will pull up Arteezy, but Weeha will finish the jump. Arteezy, no! He's protected for the moment. Surviving with a spin, he'll back out. As Team Secret, they came for kills. They have only taken the Tombstone, but they've got a lot of cooldowns now out of EG. And they want to rotate top. The Radiant Creeway's pushed in through mid, so they can attack into the Tier 3 tower if they so desire. PPD, no swap available. The Monkey King bar now done on Arteezy. He's finally got some direct damage.
But this is more than good enough for Secret to probably end the game right here. Omni Slash, Swap, and Tombstone all being on cooldown. This is a very easy siege.
Well, we'll see if they can achieve it. Arteezy moving forward, that defensive weave. Secret's getting so much armor, and Envy, he just goes after Universe. gets stunned up for the moment, but Misery, a quick follow-up. They still haven't brought down the nine stock, but Arteezy defensive spin once again, the shackle. It latches on Fear. There's no decays. Look at the damage. PBD swaps him down, but still Weeha finishes the job. PBD trying to run back out. Some male side of fist. It can't do enough damage. He's cleaned up the green wave, but he can't clean up the Heroes of Secret, who have now picked up a double kill in the hands of Weeha. PBD actually has to wait inside the shards, but GG! EG will be knocked out of the winner's bracket final by Team Secret. And Team Secret advance themselves forward into the grand final of the Frankfurt Major.
And these games have been so exceptionally good. I think a lot of people are expecting this to be the grand final matchup as well.